So welcome to the first lecture in the series of the thyroid hormones, which will be covered in the pharmacology subject. And this series would deal with, in every part, I'll be dealing with secretion, the synthesis, and then the various thyroid disorders along with their management. So if you like my videos, kindly hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. And I would be always welcome to any kind of comments that you have for any improvement. So starting now, getting back and starting with the thyroid hormones, this part would be dealing just with a general introduction. And we know that thyroid is an important endocrine gland of the body, which governs the metabolic rate of all the cells. And not only that, it is very important for the normal growth and development of the individual, the musculoskeletal system as such. The major role is even seen in the central nervous system development, and especially this is more important in infancy and childhood, as it leads to improvement in the memory, in the help in the learning process. Therefore, in case of deficiency in this age group, which is in the infancy and the childhood, cretinism develops, and that leads to the decrease in the intelligent quotient or IQ of these children. They are mentally retarded. In case this happens in the adult, the deficiency of thyroid hormones, which is called as mixed edema, because they have the central nervous system already developed, so they will not have any mental retardation as such, but they will be presenting with mental sluggishness. So such is the importance of the thyroid hormones for our body and the need to know them and how we can treat its decrease in level, that is hypothyroidism, or its increase in the level in the body, which is hyperthyroidism, which we'll be talking about in the subsequent lectures. So first coming, the location of the, where is it located? We see here, it is located right in the interior part of the neck, in front of the trachea. And this thyroid gland, it has two lobes and it's joined by isthmus. So at each pole, on the posteriorly, we have four parathyroid glands. And these parathyroid glands, they are going to secrete parathyroid hormones. While the thyroid glands is going to secrete the important hormones, which is the T4, T3, reverse T3, which is the inactive form of T3, and calcitonin. So these are the various hormones by the thyroid glands. And because the calcitonin, which is secreted by the parathyroid cells, they have an entirely different function as compared to the rest of the thyroid hormones. So this will be dealt separately. And in this section of thyroid hormones, we will be concentrating on mainly these three hormones. And out of this also, you will see that this is the most active out of all the three. This is the inactive form. So the major functions is usually done by the T3, that is the triiodothyronate. Coming to the regulation of how it is now regulated in the body, their secretion. So it is regulated by the higher centers, and the higher centers we have, which is the hypothalamus, and the next is the, in the anterior pituitary. From the hypothalamus, so whenever there is any stimulus for release or there is decrease in the blood levels of these hormones, so the thyroid releasing hormone, you know, the releasing hormone is released from hypothalamus, travels through the blood and reaches the interior pituitary cells where there are thyrotropes present. And these thyrotropes lead to the release of thyroid stimulating hormone. Thyroid stimulating hormone is further going to act on the thyroid follicles. And these are the thyroid follicles, and this you see are the receptors for the thyroid stimulating hormones. And the receptors for the thyroid stimulating hormones, these are the G protein coupled receptors. And when they are stimulated, they are going to cause the synthesis of T3, T4, as well as the reverse T3. Now, not how they are going to improve or enhance the synthesis of T3, T4, they are going to influence the synthesis at various steps. Whether it is at the point of iodide trapping, whether it is at the point of coupling, whether it is at the point of synthesis of thyroglobulin, or they increase the blood supply to the gland, they increase the size and the number of follicles. So they have all these functions by which they are going to enhance or increase the synthesis of T3 and T4 in the body. Now, See, nothing in the body, the nature has provided the system as such that nothing would be left unchecked. So to provide a check, there is a negative feedback system. And the negative feedback system ensures that there is no, you know, increased, there's continuous formation of these hormones even when it is not required by the body. So when the levels are sufficient or there is increase in the levels of these three, there is a natural check on the higher centers, on the posterior pituitary as well as the hypothalamus, and there is either decrease in the release of these hormones, and this anterior pituitary becomes insensitive to the effects of DRH. So it becomes insensitive to the effects of DRH, and when it becomes insensitive, there is obviously decrease in the TSH levels, which would decrease the further production of T3 and T4. And when there is deficiency, so when there is decrease in the levels, obviously the negative feedback is going to be eliminated. There's no negative feedback and there would be enhancement in the secretion of TRH and TSH. And it will lead to enhanced production of T3 and T4. So this is how there is regulation of the thyroid hormones in the body. So in the next topic, we'll be discussing about how they are secreted, how they are synthesized, secreted, and then ultimately metabolized in the body. So thank you.